like convenience, like there are meals ready to eat that we can just pour water and heat up anytime. There are, which is also used in the military, and the machine use also allows workers to have lesser work needed. Because this machine, as shown in this picture, has a conveyor belt system. This system helps separate food ingredients and pack them accordingly without the need of having a worker being there. Yeah, and it also removes byproduct automatically, so that it has better hygiene also. And technology also brings about longer shelf life and reduced wastage. How it brings about longer shelf life? Some examples are vacuum packing. The vacuum packing machine vacuums back food, like meat products and other products, which remove the chance of it having coming in contact with oxygen in the air, so the meat won't oxidize and won't spoil through oxidation. There's also instant food like instant ramen, where they remove all the moisture and so that it won't spoil because there's no moisture in it anymore. Similar with freeze-dried food, where they freeze the food and then remove the moisture, keeping it in a freeze-dried state. And also high-pressure processing. High-pressure processing replaces the... Okay, so high-pressure processing replaces the heat in food processing, so it creates an environment where bacteria and other harmful stuff cannot survive in, so it allows the food to be kept for longer without spoiling. It also allows for a lower production cost because it increases the amount of workers needed in a factory, as the machine is very efficient and don't need workers to do some of the jobs as the first, like how you remove the byproduct, like skin or meat and all. And the machines are also very energy efficient, so the energy cost won't be that high, as this machine are made to be green and energy efficient. The machines also have low maintenance costs, so overall it will lower the production cost in making food and processing food. Now I'll pass the time over to Gwen to talk more about how it